set apart, completely independent of all of his creations. That means that God is who he said he is. That God is the God of the Bible. And his son, Jesus Christ, to whom we reject, to whom we slap in the face and say, what you did on the cross, that don't mean anything to me. No, you know, we gotta not allow it to mean something to us. Because God has given his best. His best was his son, Jesus Christ. For the Bible says, Genesis 1 and 26, let us make man, not our likeness. After our likeness, in our image, and after our likeness. Yes, if you look at yourself, you see the physicality of you, but we're not talking about the physicality. We're talking about the nature of God, the characteristics of God. That's what we're actually talking about. God wants us to be like him in character, in love, in righteousness, in justice, to love each other, as the Bible says. The Bible says, and we must love each other by this. Y'all all men know that you are my disciples. If you have love one to another. But how can we have love? We live in a world, a cold world, a heartless world, a world that has violated their conscience. We violate our conscience. I'll put myself before you. Because at the foot of the cross of Christ, we are all on the same level. For the Bible says, all that sin and comes short of the glory of God. That means everyone that's born. Those that have gone on before, those that are older than you, those that are the same age right now, those that come after you. Scripture is very clear that all have sinned and come short of the character or the nature of God. Why? Because Adam sinned in the garden. Adam sinned before a holy God. He sinned before a holy God. So that put us all in the same category. There's no different category. There's only one race, that's the human race. It's not black, white, Chinese,